What is up, Pats Nation? It is Patriots Global here, back with another video. So by the title, you can obviously tell that we're going to be talking about Trey Flowers in today's video and his future with the New England Patriots. So first off, why am I even talking about this? Why am I talking about Trey Flowers and his future with the Patriots right now? Well, for those of you who don't know, Trey Flowers actually only has 1 year left on his contract, which is going to be this coming season. And he was by far one of the best defensive players on the Patriots last year, and was by far probably the best Patriot on that defensive line. In a photo I saw today on Instagram, on PFF's Instagram, they actually graded him as one of the highest graded players on defense, that is, in his draft class. Now, there has been multiple times that Belichick has just gotten rid of guys and just thought that he could replace them no matter what and be fine. I mean, we saw it with Chandler Jones, and we still are trying to fill the void of him. And we've seen it just multiple other times. That was just one example I had off the top of my head. But the Patriots just struggle so much at the defensive position. Well, not necessarily at the defensive position, but at the defensive line position, especially when it comes to defensive end. And to be quite honest, guys, that was a big reason we lost the Super Bowl last year. Belichick could not retain Chris Long. He could not retain Jabal Sheard. He basically got rid of all of them, thinking that he could replace them, and he could not. We had the worst defensive line last year, I swear, guys. And ultimately, it was part of the reason that we lost the Super Bowl. Last season, Trey Flowers played 14 games with 45 tackles, 6.5 sacks, 28 QB hits, and 24 pressures. Now, in his rookie season, he was injured, so he missed the entire rookie season, and he's actually 24, so he is a very young defensive player still, so he still has time to progress, and in his, 2 years, I think he's been playing in the NFL, he is just growing so much each year. In fact, many people have him becoming a Pro Bowler next year. I'm not just talking Patriots fans. I'm talking football analytics, PFF, just a lot of people have Trey Flowers becoming a Pro Bowler next year. Like I mentioned before, the Pats just have so much trouble getting good players on their defense, on their defensive line, especially when it comes to the draft. I mean, honestly, Belichick and drafting good defensive ends and stuff like that, just it doesn't always work out. I mean, once in a blue moon. I mean, the 2016 season, that defensive line was one of the best defensive lines that I've seen in the Patriots for a while. And then Belichick basically let most of them walk. So if they get rid of Flowers, it just creates such a big hole that the Patriots are just still trying to fill that void. And if Flowers hit the road, guys, I cannot express enough how much more issues that will bring to our defensive line. It's just so important. You're going to hear me say this throughout this video multiple times. It is just so important to sign Trey Flowers. Honestly, I have him possibly being one of the most important players that will be a free agent after the season. Just by far such an important Patriot to keep. Now, I feel like after Bill saw what happened with Chandler Jones and basically the troubles we had, how Chandler Jones went to be one of the leading sack players, became a Pro Bowler, first team All Pro, just this star player that Belichick basically just gave the Cardinals for free. I just feel like he knows how important Flowers is, and that he is not just a wide receiver or running back, and that he is very important and he cannot just let him walk. But still, Bill is just a very stubborn guy, so we cannot count on him making Trey Flowers a priority. Obviously, he knows how important he is to sign, but like I said, Belichick is very stubborn. Little interesting fact is that this past season, Trey Flowers led the NFL in quarterback hits. Now, yes, of course, it is always preferred to get sacks and, you know, all that. But the fact that he is applying, yeah, applying this much pressure, and that fact that he led the NFL out of all players, he led the NFL in quarterback hits. So he is getting there, and each year, like I said, he is progressing. So if he can just keep doing him, he could turn out to be one of the best defensive ends in the game with time. Now, I heard this little trade scenario involving Trey Flowers, and I actually kind of want to share it with you guys. So the trade is the Patriots trading Flowers to Carolina for a fifth round pick and wide receiver Curtis Samuel. And let me just say, when I read this, all I had to do was cringe and just say how much BS it was. Now, don't get me wrong, by no means is Trey Flowers safe on the team. I mean, is anyone honestly really safe, to be quite honest? But yeah, Trey Flowers is just definitely not safe on the team, especially when he's set to become a free agent next season and we'll have a hard time retaining him. And not to mention, he will most likely demand money that the Pats will question about giving him. But I still think maybe Bill has learned from his mistakes. Yes, I'm hinting at the Chandler Jones trade, but I think that he's just a little bit smarter than to add another wide receiver and give away one of the best players on the Patriots. Basically, what I understood from the article was basically just that Curtis Samuel would bring a lot of speed to the wide receiver core, which is something that we lost when we let go of Brandon Cooks. But we have Philip Dorsett if we really need that. We have Cordarrelle Patterson. There's just no sense of adding another wide receiver for one of the best defensive players in the game. It would literally be such a steal by Carolina. Now, the market is already high for Flowers, and if he keeps progressing like he does every season, it will be harder and harder for the Pats to retain him and get him under contract long term. Now, the Pats are not necessarily in a rush. I mean, they have the whole season, then they have next free agency if they choose to sign him, but ultimately, time is ticking. Look at it like this. The longer they wait, the longer it could potentially be harder to retain Trey Flowers. So pretty much, unless Trey Flowers has such a terrible off season, which I extremely doubt will happen, it will be harder for the Pats to get him under contract long term, because he's going to keep doing better and he's going to be getting way better offers than I'm sure the Patriots are going to be giving him. Now, the Pats do, they're supposed to have some pretty decent cap space next year. It definitely will be better than it was this year. This year, we really just had no money whatsoever, but we will definitely have, we are supposed to have a very decent amount of cap. And from the sounds of it, Flowers is worth and is supposed to get somewhere between 8 to 10 mil a year, especially with what defensive linemen are getting paid for now. I know that the Vikings just paid some defensive end that a lot of people haven't even heard about for about like 8 to 10 million a year. So yeah, by no means is Trey Flowers going to be a 4 mil type of guy. The Pats added some great additions. I mean, they added Adrian Claiborne, who will be able to play the other end. So the Patriots are already trying to fill the void and are trying to fix that defensive line problem. But if they get rid of Trey Flowers, they're just going backwards again. But what do you think? Do you think the Patriots are going to get Flowers signed? If you do think they will get him signed, when do you think they'll get him signed? Do you think that Trey Flowers is worth the money? And if not, what do you think the Patriots should do with him? Should they trade him? And if they trade him, who should they trade him for? What kind of pick should they trade him for? A lot of questions you could go with this, but I want to know what you guys thinking about this. Make sure you guys like and subscribe, as it helps me so freaking much. Share this video with as much friends as you can possibly think of. Let's grow the Patriots global community. But other than that, that is it for today's video. I'll catch you guys in another one, Pats Nation.